One, two, three, four. Could you just advise the other students as well how you, you know, try to log into the Zoom? Because I think there are some who are experiencing some problems. I do not know whether it's technical error from their end. Like how you guys have been able to key in the password, if you're able to just guide someone in the group as well, because there is, I think, one is Debbie who's trying to log in and she's not really able to log in. If you could just pass around a message. Meanwhile, we'll begin with the class. Can you do that for me? Because I think I received a message, because after this, I'll not be able to pay attention to my mobile phone the moment I begin with the class.
Okay, how is it? I hope that the other remaining classmates will should join us. But you are...
There is Debbie who is trying to enter the class.
Okay.
And she says that she's not able to key in the password.
Repeat again?
She is there on the WhatsApp group and she has said that she's not able to key in the password.
Excuse me, teacher, your voice is low, please.
Okay, 1 minute.
Can you come to us your microphone or your earbud?
I'll try to increase the volume here.
Okay.
Okay, what I was talking about is there is one Miss Debbie who's trying to key in the password and trying to enter this classroom, but she isn't able to. Could you just assist her, please? Because how you are able to, you know, access this passcode, and if you could just advise her, because I've told her she has to just click on the link and key in the password that is given there. And yet another thing is, this is a recurring meeting. So we'll be meeting every Wednesday at 8 a.m. your time, today being the first class. So that's the reason I try to, you know, give some leverage and wait for some more time. And normally the buffering time for entering the class is around 15 minutes, 1-5. But after, for your attendance to be granted to you, it would be 15 minutes. I wouldn't mind to give you 15 minutes, 1-5. But after that, of course, the student is permitted to enter the class, but I may not be able to be in a position to really, grant them attendance. I'm sure you know that attendance carries marks, okay? But this being the first class, we can be light on this issue. But from the next class, 15 minutes is the buffering time to enter the class. After 15 minutes, you will be allowed to enter the class, but attendance will not be awarded. That's one thing. Second thing is the class begins at 8 a.m. sharp. I mean, it's going to be there, but sometimes probably due to technical problems, there is a possibility like here and there, 5 minutes here and there. However, you are permitted to, you know, enter the class even by 8:05, but 8:05, the lecture is going to begin, okay? So that's the second thing. The third thing is, now I think we'll begin with the class, and I believe that you have already learned the first two chapters of strategic human resource development and management. I've gone through the slides, what you have already learned, and I believe that you've already got deep insight into this, the first two chapters, and you already understand what is strategic human resource development. So for this class, I will just brush up over this, the first and the second chapter, okay, as an introduction, and I'm going to, pulverize the entire chapters. I'm going to, give it to you like a capsule, I have encapsulated it into simple words so that you will be able to understand, because I believe you already know what it is, what is strategic human resource development. You have already attended two classes. There's already the video recording in your classroom. That is a Google Classroom. It's already uploaded. So let's move further. So what is strategic human resource development? What is strategic human resource development? Can anyone tell me? in your own words. And yet another thing I would like to make you comfortable with is, please feel free to answer in the class and interact in the class. Classroom interaction also, I'll be keeping in mind for awarding some marks. And there is no right or a wrong answer. I don't mind if you express your opinion. Are you understanding me? It's not necessary that we know all the answers to all the questions, but at least an attempt. I would really appreciate the attempt on your part. So please feel free to answer me. There is no right or a wrong answer. I'm not going to say anything, you know. So if you're really able to answer and you're able to articulate what is in your mind, sometimes you may have the answer in your mind, but you may not be able to articulate it and express it in words. But in this class, I'm giving you the opportunity as well as the leverage to speak whatever you want, which is pertinent to the question that is asked to you within the present or the parameters of the subject. And of course, I'd be happy for that. So what is strategic human resource development? Okay, no problem. What is a strategy? Having already attended two classes, which was taken by your other lecturer, the other faculty member. So I understand that I'm sure you already are aware of what is a strategy and what is strategic human resource development. So, okay, the first question is, what is a strategy? Forget about human resource development. What is a strategy? Let me put it to you in simple terms now. Let us go to the root level. What is a strategy?
Strategy, teacher, strategy is a plan of action designed to achieve a long or short time target.
Good. So you are saying that it is what? Can you repeat for the class? It is a?
Clarify.
You're right. Tell me.
Teacher, again, I repeat.
Yeah. So you said what it is. What is the first key word that you use right now? Tell me, what is a strategy?
Strategy is a plan of action.
Plan of action. Perfect. So strategy is a plan of action to achieve either the short-term goals or the long-term goals of the organization. Again, if you try to constrict the definition in simple words, you could say that it is a plan of action to achieve the organizational goals, right? So we know that every organization has a mission and a vision. So I've always been with this keywords of mission, vision, and mission, or mission of any organization. And this is what I advise even to my clients. And this is what I've written articles about, that every organization should have a mission and a vision. And normally they have that. And, around this mission and the vision the organization has, they would devise organizational goals. Now, these organizational goals, if you just have a goal in mind, it wouldn't suffice. To achieve the goal, you need a strategy. So you said that, what is a strategy? So you said that a strategy is something relating to a plan of action. That means there is a plan of action to achieve this goal, right? So that is a strategy. Now, what is human resource development or human resources? Forget about development. What is human resources? Anyone can answer me. Now, Abdullah, he said that it is, he has given me the definition of a strategy. Okay. So now what is human resources? I know you know the answers, but let us go to the root level to set the perspective and then come to what is, strategic human resource development or management, because sometimes, you know, you, they will not big things, but you know, when a question, simple question is asked, even for your exam, you may not be able to express it in your words. So that's the reason I'm asking this question to you: what is strategic human resource development or management? And for that, I already asked you what is strategy, and one of you have given me the answer. Now you will have to give me or tell me what is, or explain to me as if I don't understand, believe that I really do not know anything, and you tell me what is human resources.
Okay, let me try that question. Can you hear me, teacher?
Yeah, sure. What is human resources?
If I try human resources, is the framework of helping employees develop their personal and organizational skills, knowledge, and abilities.
Okay. And in simple words, Mohammed says that, thank you, Abdirazak. And let me go to the chat. If possible, avoid the chat. You know why? Because I appreciate that as well. But for me to go through the chat, I have to, you know, it's a little bit time consuming. So I have to go through the chat messages and check like what is really, you know, mentioned there. Okay, Mama just sent a direct message. I'm not able to access here. Okay. So he says, human resources is a set of people who make up the workforce of an organization, business sector, industrial economy, and a narrow concept is human capital, the knowledge and skills which the individuals command. And similar terms include manpower, labor, personnel, associates, or simply people. Okay, wow. So I like the word people. So human resources is, let me just admit another person into the classroom. I'm sorry. Okay, so human resources is nothing but, in simple terms, people. Where? In the organization, the workforce, associates, whoever are involved in the organization. Now, you spoke, one of you spoke about strategy, and two of you spoke about what is human resources. So you know that it is something strategy pertaining to human resources. You know what's a strategy, and the aim of strategy is to achieve organizational goals. Then you know, link human resources and what is development and management. Now you already know what is development, like how it progresses, and the management is the art of managing people. So what is strategic human resource management? Can anyone answer? Forget about what you read and studied. Just based on what we discussed in this classroom, if you could just give me a link between what is strategic human resource management or development, what it is. Give me the answer. I know you know the answer, in fact.
Excuse me, teacher. Repeat again that question.
Okay. I said that one of you has already given me the answer of what is a strategy. You said it's a plan of action to achieve, you know, long-term or short-term goals. And then we try to constrict the answer and say that, you know, a strategy is a plan of action to achieve organizational goals. One. Again, I asked you, what is human resources? And somebody said that human resources is something pertaining to people, right? Simply people within the organization, of course, the workforce and so on. So now I'm asking you, what is strategic human resource development or management? What is strategic human resources development? Yeah, tell me, Abdifita, you have raised your hand.
Yes, teacher. Human resource management development is, I define human resource management development is a process that develop employee or other part of organization employee to develop the employee education or employee skills to develop the organization.
Mm-hmm. That's great. A good answer. Okay. Can you just link in simple terms the definition what we gave for strategy and human resources? Anyone? That's a good answer, Abdullahi. Can you give me a very simple answer just from your mind based on what we have answered in, I mean, discussed in the class? Yes, Deborah?
So strategic human resource development is, this is an action plan which helps the employees to develop themselves in terms of career development, organization development, and the training and development in order to increase their skills, their work performance so that they can reach or achieve the organizational objectives.
Great. Okay, so yes, so this is what you have already learned in the past. I understand. So that's great. Thank you so much, Deborah. Well, now what we discussed today in the class is going to the root level. We said that a strategy, we spoke about strategy and human resources. So let us now connect these two and say that strategic human resources development or management deals with the development or management of people, linking it with strategic management, which deals with, or you could say that the marriage or the union between strategic management and human resources management is strategic human resource management. Having a planned action for achievement of the organizational goals of the company through the workforce or through the people in the organization is strategic human resource management. Now, how you achieve it, Deborah is giving the answer. She says that in the form of, you know, what did you say, Deborah? You said, spoke about, you know, enhancing the skills in your own words. I understood that you spoke about enhancing the skills of the people within the organization, having in mind the organization goals. So that's great. So I understand that you already know what is strategic human resource development. So you already have got them, you know, kind of an insight into the subject. So still, let it be like a revision. Let's go through our slides and go further. And I've tried to keep it in simple words and in simple terms. And I'm going to give you also some points for the subject and which you can, you know, use it for your examination as well. Today, we are going to learn about the strategy of human resources. It is a systematic process of developing. Well, Mohammed is gone into the depth and saying it's a, see, if you give me, I said, if you give me in the chat form, it's difficult for me because I have to go back to the chat. Yes, good. A strategy of human resource development is a systematic process of developing the skills and competence of people through talent development, leadership development, employee development, performance development, training development process to enable the organization to sustain its goals. Okay, I think you've missed it, or maybe I'm not able to read it. So good. So it's basically training the people within the organization and giving them an insight into what is the goal of the organization and training them to achieve those goals. So that means every company should understand that the people within the structure or the human resources is an important investment. That means if they invest in the right people to and place them at the right position and train them towards achieving the organization goals and introducing them towards the goals to gain a competitive edge in the market. So the human resources is going to cooperate, or the workforce is going to cooperate towards achieving that goals. And that is going to really, you know, pump up the organization or thrust the organization to a higher level and help them gain that competitive advantage in the market. It's going to help them gain the competitive advantage in the market, one. Two, it's going to help them to, you know, help the organization to sustain in the market pressures and move forward with the help of the human resources, trained human resources within the organization. So basically, the entire unit is working towards, you know, pushing the company towards achieving the goals, achieving profits, achieving the competitive edge, achieving even sustenance in the market. Because it's not always about profits. Of course, it's about profits, but what is more important here is sustaining. Like, for example, like without going into like, you know, the theory part of it. If it, I just want you to think, because if you think, I know it's easy for you. I'm sure you know about how the world has been really attacked, the markets of the world really fell drastically during this COVID pandemic. Of course, we are not entirely out of it, but this phase of during these 2 years, you must have observed, you must have read and experienced within your own city, country, and even you must have read or even watched in the news how the markets fell and how people lost jobs. So there are many companies which shut down because of the pandemic. They were not able to sustain themselves. Are you understanding me? So sometimes it's not always about profit making. It's also about sustaining yourselves and, you know, trying to sail against the wind and remaining there. So strategic human resource development or management helps in even sustaining the company while they aim or look forward. It's like it's forward looking. It looks forward to the organization goals being achieved and also sustaining. So I'd like to add the word sustenance in the market, sustaining themselves in the market. Apart from achieving the goals, keeping their vision on the goals, you know, you sustain yourself in the market with the help of people. And why I'm saying this, this is what my personal experience of what I have seen across in certain companies also, where, you know, the companies weren't able to pay their employees on time, where there has been salary delays of 2 or 3 months, and some of them had to just quit the jobs, and some of them were just terminated. And I know of companies where employees stuck to the organization even when there was delay in payment of 2 months, 3 months. So now you see here, investing in the right human resources where the workforce sticks to the company through hard times and helps the company beat the winds that is, you know, blowing against them. And with the help of the human resources, where they have the organization goals in mind, they together, you know, sustain the pressures of the dwindling market or the position, their dwindling position in the market. Are you understanding me? So this is, you know, simply put, it is not about just achieving organizational goals. It's also about having your vision or your being, you know, having your eye fixed on the organization goals. Look for a competitive edge, look for growth, profits, as well as sustenance. Now let's move through our slides. Having said the perspective, mute your mic, please. We're going to do the first and the second chapter together because we've already done that. It's just like, I'm just trying to recapitulate the entire stuff, what you've learned already, just as an introduction. So you already know the meaning, but let's see what the slides say. Now, I begin with a sentence of treat your employees as an investment. Okay, so employees are basically an investment. That is, the right employees, you put the right employee to the right position, it is an investment. So the management of human resources has evolved over the years, which I know that you understand this part of it. It has grown, it has evolved over the years. It has grown over the years, the management system of it, grown from the embryonic stage, that is from it being a, I wouldn't use the word baby, embryonic in the sense from being an embryo, like from the right inception, you know, it has grown from nothingness. It has grown, it has developed. They had traditional way of handling human resources. And now we have gone to another level of strategic human resource management and development. So the management of human resources has evolved over the years, and the system is being upgraded with its evolution and development. So equipping the company's human resources, and you already said what the human resource is, equipping them and you equip them to the current developments and upgrading their skills and implementing the advanced changes in the system is what is normally done as traditional management systems upgrade. So what they do is they will upgrade the knowledge of the present human resources with the current developments, upgrade their skills, have training programs, and implement the advanced changes in the system. So this is what happens in a traditional management systems upgrade. And let's see next. However, equipping and upgrading the human resources to the emerging systems embryonically at its inception with, as one of you said, planned strategic effort. You know, what is a strategy? So strategizing, the efforts to train them to the emerging systems, as well as a planned strategic effort, is strategic human resource development. The strategic human resource development is forward thinking process rather than the current, that is the present. So it's forward thinking. Traditional process differs as its nature from the strategic process. For example, implementing strategic training of employees for future emerging trends for upgradation of the skills is an example of a traditional process. Now, simply put again, strategic human, so this being the first class, I'm sure you will not be aware of what goes on in my class. Sometimes we will get disconnected, okay? And if you get disconnected, please join back again, okay? So we'll be continuing the lecture. So going back to the slide again, simply put, strategic human resource management and development is strategic sharpening of human resources within the structure to meet the company's strategy goals. This is exactly what you said. But I've used the word sharpening in the sense that is upgrading the skills of the employees and knowledge of the employees, training them to that extent is like sharpening the human resources within the structure to meet the company's strategy goals. Now, the process. Now, in the process of SHRD, that is strategic human resource development, the company equips its employees with the information of its developmental goals. So I want you to remember this keyword here. The company equips its employees with information of its development goals and links it with the implementation of each employee in their sphere of work with the aim of contributing towards the goals of the company. Now, this sort of transparency encourages better employee performance, and a remarkable development can be seen even in the progress of the company. As I gave you the example, during this COVID pandemic, there were many companies which were shaken. However, they could some of them could really sustain with the help of the human resources within their structure, despite not paying them their salaries on time and having a delay of nearly, 3 to 4 months. So what has encouraged them to stay is the transparency between the employee and, constant upgradation by giving them training, and transparency between the management and the workers. And that transparency encourages better employee performance because they already now know about the goals of the organization. That leads to a remarkable development that will be quite evident even in the progress that the company makes. Now, what is a strategy? One of you has already given me the answer. It simply means a defined plan of action for implementation to achieve the set goals. So one of you spoke about goals being short-term and long-term. So you see, we are learning together. Are you understanding me? So this is what, this is the kind of role that an interactive session plays. You know the answer, you articulate the answer, and then while we teach you, you already know what is being taught in the class, and it's easy for you and for me as well. So strategy simply means a defined plan of action for implementation to achieve the set goals. And I'm reiterating, as one of you said, that goals are short-term and long-term. So management study guide defines strategy in the business management perspective as an action that managers take to attain one or more of the organization's goals. Strategy can also be defined as a general direction set for the company and its various components to achieve a desired state in the future. So strategy results from detailed strategic planning process. So before I go forward to the definitions and quoting different authors and experts in the management field, I'd like to just hold on for a moment and remind you that when a question comes for your exam, like what is strategic management, what is strategic human resource development and management? So you will have to give your answer in this way as it is mentioned in the slide. And after you give what is in your mind as well, in general terms, then you will have to go on to quote various authors and management experts. And when you're quoting them, it has to be in inverted commas. Author John Walton defines SHRD as strategizing the integration of HRD with formulation and implementation with a long-term view of human resource policy. In other words, it is how HRD is applied and aligned to achieve the organization goals and objectives strategically. So he simply has worded it after giving his definition. He's saying he just talks about the alignment to achieve the organization goals and objectives strategically. Now, Gary Dessler defines strategic human resource management as formulating and executing human resource policies and practices that produce the employees' competencies. One of you even, I remember, spoke about competency, employee competency and behavior that the company needs to achieve its strategic aims. What I'm trying to, encourage you is more than literally by hearting the subject is you understand the concept, and then it's easy for you to, you know, remember the concept and then write it for your exams. And just even you're reading something and you're answering. So more than that, if you already know it here, what it is in simple terms, so you'll be able to write for your exams what it is and then what you have probably by hearted. The definitions by at least minimum two authors or management experts, you can give it to me for your exams. Then Wright and McMahon defines strategic human resource management as the pattern of planned human resource deployments and activities and intended to enable an organization to achieve its goals. So here they talk about deploying or appointing human resources and aligning even the human resource activities with the intention of achieving organization goals. So it's all about strategizing human resources to achieve organization goals. So you see, everything is everything basically hovers around or revolves around organizational goals. From the above definition, strategic orientation of the company towards building strategic goals and designing patterns for the upgradation of its internal systems, including human resources, is a sine qua non that it is absolutely essential for gaining remarkable business advantage in the business world and market. So why are we strategizing human resources? It's to achieve goals. Why do you want to achieve those goals? To sustain or to gain an advantage in the market, to gain a competitive advantage or a competitive edge in the market, in the business world, in the business market. And that is, a sine qua non, strategizing the internal, systems, including the human resources, is a sine qua non, or it's absolutely essential for gaining a remarkable business advantage in the business world or business market. Now, apart from that, you could also use the word sustenance, competitive edge, gaining competitive edge, gaining competitive advantage, achieving profits, bearing in mind the organization goals, and sustaining in the market. Now, why the word sustenance? I'm trying to drill it into your mind, the word sustenance, because that's what we have experienced for the past 2 years, sustaining ourselves and sailing against the winds of you know, market losses and so on. So therefore, it can also be said that the marriage or the union, definition is the union or the marriage of human resource management with strategic management. It's strategic human resource management. And strategic management deals with a plan of action for achieving organizational goals, planning, implementation, and so on. So I won't go into that. But the marriage of the union of strategic management with strategic human resource management or human resource management is strategic human resource management. The most simplest example, definition, I'm repeating. The marriage between strategic management and human resource management is strategic human resource management. Then you can also begin your answer with this and then go on to explain what is a strategy, what is strategic management, then what is human resource management. And then you say, therefore, human resource management, the marriage of human resource management and strategic management is strategic human resource management. For your exams, a question can come. The marriage of human resource management and strategic management is strategic human resource management. Comment or elaborate. So such questions can come. Next is the SHRD models. Of course, there is traditional model of HRD, which we all know. And next is the strategic HRD model, which we are concerned about for this class.